Outside leg kick early there. Wakamatsu. McLaren sliding backwards out of the range of that jab. Fake there from the Australian. Left of screen. Jab two, hook overhand right from Wakamatsu. The heavy artillery early from Wakamatsu.
Ooh, Wakamatsu's throwing heat early in the first 30 seconds. But beautiful timing by Reece to go right underneath. But what balance shown by Yuya Wakamatsu. I like the defense of that takedown. It was able to separate the hands.
Yeah, Reece timed that takedown really well on Wakamatsu's entry, and Wakamatsu still was able to defend that.
Always the intensity in the eyes of Reece McLaren as Wakamatsu circles counterclockwise. Tipping bolo punch there from Wakamatsu. They tie up center of the circle. Top position here for Wakamatsu.
Nice takedown landed there by Yuya Wakamatsu. Is able to reap the outside leg and end up on top. But this is Reece McLaren's world. Reece has got a very active guard and some nasty submissions off his back. Look at that. Immediately threatens an omoplata. Look at that guard, very active off his guard, not just sitting there holding him in an enclosed guard. He's immediately starting to attack with the submissions. Yu's got to be very careful right here.
Yeah, he's got that arm isolated. Initially, it looked like he was going for an arm drag, but then he was going to set up a reversal, but he ended up going straight for that arm bar.
As I said, so inventive and so aggressive with his submission repertoire is Lightning Reece McLaren. Came agonizingly close to almost winning the world title against Viviana Fernandez.
And that was a weight class above, too.
Bantamweight, yes.
So, you know, Reece McLaren has fought the very best at flyweight and bantamweight.
He almost had Viviana. He almost had him a whisker away from beating the great Viviana Fernandez.
And some say if he wasn't joking around so much, put the aggression on Bibiano, who could have had it.
I like the way Reece is working between his half guard and butterfly. They're back to their feet, but it was good work, the transition between the two there.
Wild punch there from Wakamatsu. McLaren wanting to trade with him with the hands. Switches to a wide southpaw stance here as Reece looks for a yokogeri sidekick. Doesn't throw it though.
Wakamatsu almost hit him with a hooking.
Overhand right, misses with the knee as Reece pressed back against the wire here. Did you understand a little Japanese there? A lot of instructions coming from the corner of Wakamatsu, not so many from the Aussie corner.
Yeah, Ryo Chonan is, I guess, the mastermind behind Yuya Wakamatsu's training, and we're seeing him really sort of level up. When he went up against DJ, you know, Yuya Wakamatsu had some problems with the takedown defense, and we're seeing him definitely improve in these wrestling exchanges.
Tell you what, after DJ losing to Adriano Moraes, I would love to see him against either one of these men. I mean, Wakamatsu again, but particularly against Reece McLaren. For me, that's got to happen.
I love it when top fivers compete against each other. There's so much at stake with the implications of a possible title shot.
Look at what Wakamatsu, how he's pushing Reece McLaren's head down. You know, where the head goes, the body will follow. So with his head being pushed that low, he just doesn't have the ability to lift for any kind of takedown on Wakamatsu.
Nice job. I like how he transitioned with his head and put it under the armpit. Now he's able to allow him to turn the corner. But Wakamatsu's utilizing these double underhooks really well for control.
Absolutely. There's a lot of stuff going on here. This is a real physical chess match with the grappling and wrestling game that if you don't know the fine details of this, you're missing a lot of stuff in this match.
McLaren does have 8 submissions in 14 wins. Wakamatsu has never submitted an opponent, but has knocked out 11 of them in 13 wins.
Beautifully done by Reece McLaren. Wakamatsu turns, gives up his back. Nice scramble to maintain position, end up on top. Beautifully done by Wakamatsu.
Just the aggressive grappling of Reece McLaren. Both feet on hips now from the Aussie on his back. 30 seconds remaining. What's been a tremendous opening round.
Nice butterfly sweep right there by Reece McLaren. That was beautiful.
What's the art in martial arts? Does Reece McLaren on the guard now? Full mount position for Reece, dropping down the elbow. Head movement from Wakamatsu. Oh, eats that elbow. That was a big one between the eyes. Reece McLaren hunts for a finish of the dying seconds. Slapping head kick there from Reece. Cannot afford to go into larrikin mode here. Needs to maintain focus.
What's larrikin mode?
Well, it's an Aussie term for when you joke around. Like you said, may have been his undoing against Bibiano Fernandez.
You got to translate every now and then, Michael.
Inside leg kick from Wakamatsu. Rib kick there from McLaren.
Well, that was nice. He went up high with the head kick the first time, and then he came down low to the body as McLaren changes things up.
McLaren's got to be careful on that shot. That's the second time that Wakamatsu's run that uppercut on his entry on the way in.
More of that aggressive grappling from McLaren.
Nice transition. Close to Reece with the arm bar right there. Reece McLaren. Good punches land by Yuya Wakamatsu on top. Reece McLaren closes that distance by grabbing the head.
Gained so much instruction coming from the corner of Wakamatsu, very vocal tonight. So much on the line in this one.
Good job transitioning to the tie clinch to land an elbow on the exit.
Punch, punch, I understood that one, and indeed he responds. King punch gets up to his Reece, can't affect the takedown.
That's the thing, Yuya likes those wide-angled punches. He likes big hooks and he has that overhand. So that's what Reece is timing into these entries. Good takedown defense, though, is keeping him on the feet from Yuya Wakamatsu.
McLaren holding on to that. Crystal Wakamatsu, knee there from Wakamatsu.
See, that's one thing I'm seeing from Reece McLaren inside these grappling exchanges is these hand controls. The way that he's holding the arm and the hand, he calls it Australian handcuffs. The way he's able to manipulate Yuya Wakamatsu in a lot of these positions. He loves this back position. This is where he got Mark Striegel.
That was a beautiful takedown to set up that back submission. He was pressing Wakamatsu against the cage and then just stepped back and reaped him out.
Close guard here from McLaren. 2:15 remains, second of three, now feet on hips.
What I like about Wakamatsu is he's not accepting any of these positions. He's not staying still and allowing Reece to settle into his submission attempt. He consistently looks to move in advanced position. Beautiful sweep attempt there by Reece McLaren, but beautiful balance showed by Wakamatsu.
A lot of people suggested this could be the show stealer of the entire night, and certainly it's playing out that way. A tremendously entertaining contest.
And the pace these guys are pushing, this is constant.
McLaren just backs him off with the left. Edging forward now, the Australian throws out the jab. Resets this Wakamatsu. Piotronen gives the instructions. Right hand lead there from Wakamatsu was loaded. McLaren gets under the jab, shoots in, good defense from Wakamatsu. Gets under the hook, does McLaren.
That was beautiful, the way that he was able to stop that takedown attempt by digging those underhooks to stop Reece from him. He's fully committing to that double leg. That was nice.
Knee on the inside from McLaren, you can hear the breathing.
1 minute left in the second half.
Pace, as Mitch said, the volume has been phenomenal. Overhand elbow from Wakamatsu. Almost dislodging the gum shield. McLaren drops down for a single leg unaffected.
See Wakamatsu trying to throw that uppercut on the shot again.
Can he time it? Gets on the inside of the right hand. You hear the corner of McLaren saying you're faster than him. Capitalizing your speed, Reece. I'm excited for the third round. It's going to be really good.
Especially if these guys can keep this pace, because, man, this is intense. They are not slowing down at all.
I don't think we've ever seen either Wakamatsu or McLaren in a boring contest.
10 seconds left.
Always with high output. We are going to go into the deep water. We're moving into the third round. Going to climb those rankings. especially after Demetrius Johnson getting knocked out on the TNT one by the champion Adriano Moraes. Heavy artillery in the octagon and a right hand from Wakamatsu. He's up the tempo.
That's three right hands Yuya Wakamatsu landed, and Reece McLaren ate it, came right back in for the double leg. He's put down many a foe with that right hand.
Reece McLaren may have eaten all three of those right hands, but those right hands went down on my scorecard.
As they do.
Without three judges, circle side, double leg here from McLaren, switches to a single now the Australian.
I'm impressed with Yuya Wakamatsu's takedown defense. He carries his hands real low so he can stay right into those underhook positions and prevent Reece McLaren really from changing levels and attacking those legs like he's known for.
Once again, Wakamatsu's pushing on McLaren's head. Makes it so difficult. And he tried sucking him back this time instead of pushing him against the cage. But that head control is just preventing any success with that.
You can just see the angle and the position of Reece McLaren. He just can't quite get the angle that he wants. He tries to turn the corner. He's doing everything he can and also everything correct, but Yuya Wakamatsu is operating at a different level right now with his takedown defense.
Skip up inside, fine kick from Reece. Outside leg kick was a thumper there from Wakamatsu. Jab two, missed the target. Reece goes counterclockwise. Jab two again from Wakamatsu. Jab two being called from the corner of McLaren now. Shakes it off, resets again the Aussie. 2 minutes down already in this third and final. Once again, the judges are scoring as an overall contest under our global rule set, not far by a round. Outside leg kick from Wakamatsu.
Yeah, I'll tell you, Reece has got to get, he's got to get himself active here. You saw that jab right there by Wakamatsu, the outside leg kick by Wakamatsu, and he's starting to really pull away on my scorecard right here. I'm assuming he's doing the same thing on the official judges' scorecard as well.
Wakamatsu, McLaren, both in southpaw stance, single leg attempt here from McLaren. Maintains his vertical base though, does Wakamatsu. Some hammer strikes here from the Japanese athlete.
Good balance by Wakamatsu again. It's interesting because Wakamatsu earlier this week was telling me that he believes Reece McLaren gets frustrated when things don't go his way. And I gotta be wondering if he's frustrated right now because things don't look to be going his way because of Yuya Wakamatsu's stellar takedown defense.
Absolutely, and you can see on that last shot there that the shots for Reece are just getting further and further out. Like, he's taking bigger risks on these shots.
Let's go, let's walk.
1 minute 40 remains. Heavy breathing from both men. The work rate has been crazy since the opening bout. Neither man has given the other an inch.
Reece needs something dramatic right here. He's got to change things up. He can't just press Wakamatsu up against the wall for 90 seconds. He's got to try to move. He's got to create something.
Hear those strikes connecting there for Wakamatsu. What is Reece hoping to do here, Dragon?
He's trying to get him down, Michael, but he just can't because Wakamatsu's keeping his base nice and wide. He's shoving the head down, and he's utilizing overhooks and underhooks to prevent Reece McLaren really getting to where he wants to be.
Makes a move now, Wakamatsu. What's McLaren got left with 40 seconds to go? Head kick from Wakamatsu, almost took his eyebrow off. Jack. Nice sprawl there from Wakamatsu.
Great control from Wakamatsu here. With, you know, being able to control the head, throw the knees.
Get up. 15 seconds to go. Wakamatsu back on control.
10 seconds.
One big Hail Mary shot for Reece McLaren. No. Wakamatsu throws a right hand. No flurry. End of the round. tremendous sportsmanship, the honor, the respect between our martial arts warriors. We are going down to the judges. Dragon, that was, as many people thought, you know, could be the show stealer.
Yeah, that was an incredible matchup in the world, but Yuya Wakamatsu just brought his game to the next level and really put on an incredible performance. Look at this. This grappling has stopped so many people in the past. Reece McLaren is known as an absolute workhorse, and these relentless attacks by Reece McLaren were all stopped, especially in the later part of that match. As the match wore on, it seemed like Yuya Wakamatsu just kept getting better and better, figuring out the strategy in those moments. Incredible job.
From the blue corner, Yuya Wakamatsu.
Reece McLaren knew it. We knew it. Little Piranha takes the win. The number four may have just advanced higher in that star-studded flyweight division. Look at the respect between them here. Back to the drawing board for McLaren. And a great victory for Yuya Wakamatsu.